So, Laura, you mentioned music, which I think is so important in both of these works we're seeing this week. Laura, we hear Philip Glass, we hear Brahms, we hear Gavin Byers, John Coltrane. So what is clear in your work for anybody who's seen it is that you love music, and and you just said that's where you're going to start. What is it about a piece of music for you that makes it something you want to make a dance to?
I don't know that I know that entirely. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I do respond visually to music, and my inner eye gets excited by certain mm-hmm. music, and I visualize the shape the music wants to take in space and in time, mm-hmm. and I usually see it in shapes, not in dance steps, mm-hmm. and it becomes intriguing to me to solve the problem of how the music wants to be told mm-hmm. in space and time.
I think I remember you telling me once that back when you were painting that you always had music on in the studio.
That's
with you.
That's right, yeah.
And so that feels like it, no matter what your artistic output, it was going to be musically driven.
Yes, it was always mm-hmm. that was first and foremost, I had to have music on when I was painting. Mm-hmm. And that must have planted a habit in my mm-hmm. creative spirit mm-hmm. of moving to music. I moved to brush with paint, or I moved bodies as mm-hmm. objects.
And you're working with a composer. So at what point, so you can't start with the music like Laura is, because you're working with a composer who's making music with you and then brings in some other sound as well.
Well, it's actually a little tiny bit different than that. We met Greg because Raja, who's one of our dancers, had met Greg at
Greg
Impulse
Haynes
Dance.
Is
yeah,
the composer.
Sorry, mm-hmm. Greg Haynes, the composer. Mm-hmm. He met Greg at Impulse Dance, and he had a CD of his music and played it for us, and we were just incredibly struck mm-hmm. by it. So we had you know, some piece of music mm-hmm. that he had not made for us, and then started this conversation with him mm-hmm. and. So it was like a little bit of both.
So you had an idea of the environment or
yeah.
something that you would
yeah.
be
yeah. living
in.
Uh-huh. And then Matt Sterrett, who's our sound designer, really worked with Greg and with us to really shape it in the way that we wanted, because you know, we wanted things where the music, where it felt like the piece starts in the middle of the whole piece, you know, and so that it drops right into it. And so in some ways the music, you know, Greg composed the music, and then Matt also composed the music in a way, or the
music in the space.
Yeah.
Yeah. And in time, like he kind of took what he had and then started manipulating the layers into new things, mm-hmm. Which for us was really great because we were able to, you know, end up having what, you know, maybe closer than what you could just have with a composer conversation that was, he's in Germany. Uh-huh. So it was, how do you tell that? He can't see what's going on. Whereas right. Matt was able to respond to what was actually then created. So it was great to have both people working.
Right, and so whereas Lars is, no matter what, John Coltrane, that piece of music is going to be 14 and a half minutes long. And that's going to be the duration of the dance.
Yeah,
so that's,
definitely. Mm-hmm, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So another thing that I was thinking is an interesting sort of complication for thinking about all of these worlds together is that Laura, you're not in the work, so you're outside it and being able to respond to it visually in addition to kinesthetically in directing it. You're outside the work. Zoe, you're inside the work. So maybe you could just talk about the difference, Laura, if you would start by talking about just the difference from being inside the work and then what it's like to be outside the work in the shaping of it, and so that you have another way of feeling the work.
Well, I haven't been inside work for a long time. Mm-hmm. I stopped dancing early so I could get outside mm-hmm. and do the looking. But I
because that seemed important to you?
I'm going to say that I am both inside and outside. Mm-hmm. That when the dance is happening, which is the only time I get to see my work, mm-hmm. I am very far inside the mm-hmm. dance as it's happening. Mm-hmm. And it's a very physical experience mm-hmm. for me. But outside the work, I'm looking very closely to see if I've painted the music properly, and it is mm-hmm. a term that I use. Mm-hmm. And I'm just trying to get it right, basically. Mm-hmm. I'm not trying to do anything sensational. I'm just trying to get it right. The music tells me something, and I'm trying to paint space in accordance with the music's mm-hmm. desires. And so I'm outside to see if I have painted that music properly. But physically, I'm very far inside the dance.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.